Now that we've calculated the electric fields, let's find the magnetic fields. The way we find the magnetic fields is using the right-hand rule. Put your thumb in the direction of propagation, your finger in, put your thumb in the direction of propagation. It always goes in the same direction as the electric field. Put your finger in the direction of the electric field, and then the resultant magnetic field will be your middle finger. So here's the magnetic field for the incident direction. Now let's do it for the reflected field. Put your thumb in the direction of propagation, put your finger in the direction of the electric field, and then the magnetic field is going to be going into the board. Here's H reflected. Let's do this for the transmitted field. Thumb in the direction of propagation, finger in the direction of the electric field, and then the magnetic field is going to end up in the same direction as the incident field does. Now let's also use our right-hand rule for X, Y, and Z. Put your thumb in the direction of Z, your finger will show you X, and your middle finger will show you Y. That means that this is the Y direction. So for our incident field, the magnetic field is Y polarized. For our transmitted field, it's also Y polarized. And for our reflected field, it's minus Y polarized. Now let's write our magnetic field using those polarizations. So H1 as a function of Z is going to have a Y polarization for the incident field and a minus Y polarization for the reflected field. Their directions of propagation are going to be the same as they were for the electric field, so let's just write those in too. Notice this is propagation in the plus Z direction, and this is propagation in the minus Z direction. Now let's handle the magnitudes. Remember that eta is E divided by H. We're looking at the magnitudes of eta. So if I want to find the magnetic field, I just take the electric field and I divide it by eta. In this case, it's eta 1. Eta 1 is going to be real if region 1 is lossless, and it's going to be imaginary or complex if region number 1 is lossy. So there's my electric there's my magnetic field for region number 1. Here is the incident magnetic field, and here is the reflected magnetic field. Now let's do that for region 2. H2 transmitted is going to be E0 plus divided by eta 2 in this case, tau 1 at O1. Those ones are not a mistake. E to the minus alpha 2z, e to the minus j beta 2z, and it's polarized in the y direction. So there are our electric and magnetic fields right here at the boundary between region number 1 and region number 2.